Hi and welcome back to class of product development and entrepreneurship. I am Hitesh Rayani, assistant professor at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. This is lecture 19, applications of digital tools and product architectures. So learning outcomes of these lectures is to learn the applications of digital tools, which are the digital tool used for the product designs and manufacturing of products. And then we learn the product architectures and types of modularities. So let's start our lecture with applications of digital tools. So the digital tools which is used for the design, product designs and manufacturings are first design tools such as computer aided designs. As we all know that computer aided design is the nothing but the tool which assists the design process. So it is the computer aided design and in which we use the 3D feature based modeling, assembly of components and surface modeling. All these things we do in computer aided design. So next is the computer aided engineering. After the manufacturing of after the virtual prototypes or virtual 3D models in particular CAD software, so we have to analyze that products or particular components in a CAE softwares like ANSYS, Nastran, HyperMesh, etc. So this CAE is nothing but the computer aided engineering, which is used to analyze the products or component. And the third is the production tools such as computer aided manufacturing. Computer aided manufacturing is the tools which is used for the manufacturing of products. Here I show the pictures of all these three digital tools which is used for the particular functions. So first CAD is used for the 3D components make or 3D prototypes. CAM is used for the computer aided manufacturing and CAE is used for the analysis of the particular component. So let's start the applications of these three digital tools which is used for the designs and manufacturing. So first is the design tool such as computer aided design. So first applications of CAD tool is the solid modeling. So solid modeling to create the solid component of desired set. Second applications of the CAD is the surface modeling. We can create the surface modeling by using the CAD. So to create the surface of the desired set. And third is the assembly. To assemble the models, more you can say the parts made by the either solid modelings or surface modelings to create the final assemblies. Next applications of the computer aided design is the drafting detailing. So after the finalizing the product, we have to make the 2D drawings of that particular product. Generally in software directly from 3D to 2D two dimensional drawing is created, but if you want to draw the 2D CAD can create 2D drawings directly in CAD software. And next is the reverse engineering. So reverse engineering, we all know it is nothing but the creations of virtual models or CAD models from the physical model. So it is used for to convert the real component into the 3D CAD models. So from that we have to use the CAD models and obviously to measurement of dimensions we have to use the techniques which is appropriate with the model. So next is the production tool such as the computer aided manufacturing. So in production tool such as computer aided manufacturing, first applications of CAM is the 3D milling. So 3D machining typically use the STL files from the 3D CAD programs as a source file. So we know that to make the computer aided manufacturing, we have to first create the 3D model in particular CAD software. So, and we have to transfer this model into the CAM software, so like MasterCAM, etc. So we have to convert this CAD files or part files into the STL file first, and then we have to transfer this file to the CAM software. So, and the requires all three axes of the mill to be able to move simultaneously to create the parts. And if we require the fourth axis, we can also add it, the fourth axis to create the turn parts. Here I show the fourth axis, the physical fourth axis, the parts which is used in milling machines, or you can say that this is also known as the CNC rotary tables, or this is used for the fourth axis rotary tables. Next application is the turning. So CAM software automates traditional turning on a lathe, including like roughing, grooving, threading and finishings. And next is the 3D printing. So 3D printing, we all know that what is 3D printing. It is nothing but pre-additive manufacturing process which is used to create the 3D prototypes or 3D prototypes by the editing of materials, and this process is nothing doing by the layer by layer. So it is the 3D printing process, and for that we have to first create the three-dimensional object, or you can say the virtual models of the shape, and it is the additive process, and here also we have to convert this 3D models into the data exchange format like STLs, and then we have to done the additive manufacturing process by the using of 3D printing. So these are the applications of computer aided manufacturing. The next tools which is used is the computer aided engineering. So CAE, you all we know that we do the CAE for the analysis of particular components to check whether the component is satisfied the old requirement or not, or how much the stress or how much the deflections is generated when the component is actually working, or when the component is subjected to loads. That all things we do in the computer aided engineering, or you can say that in analysis. So the first computer aided analysis engineering application is the finite element analysis. So in finite element analysis, we do first the structural analysis. So we have to check the statics and dynamics analysis of structures when we subject it to loads on that particular structures, and we check that whether the component is failed or not. So this for the analysis of structural analysis, we have to use the CAE. Second things, we have to use the CAE for the thermal analysis. So whenever the component is subjected to difference of temperature or subjected to temperatures, at that times we have to check the thermal stress produced on that component, and that for that we have to use the CAE. Third is the fluid mechanics analysis of the flow of fluid. So these all things we have to do in computer aided engineering. And also the next applications of CAE is the mechanisms analysis. As you all know that mechanisms is connected by the so many components, and the functional is operated by this particular mechanism. So after the assembles of all the components in softwares, we have to check the mechanisms is properly work or not. So for the mechanism analysis, we have to use the CAE. So mechanism analysis studies the behavior of mechanical systems undergoes motion. So these are the applications of computer aided engineering. Now the next topic is product architectures. So before we learn the product architectures, we must know the what is the functional elements and what is physical elements. As we know that there are all products has two elements. One is the functional element and second is the physical elements. So what is functional elements? The functional elements of the product are the individual operations and transformations that contribute to the overall performance of the product. So for example, if you consider the example of printer, so there are the functional elements in printer such as the storage of papers and communicate with the host computer. So these are the functional elements, and there are the individual operations according to the functional, and all the operations of this individual individual functional element contributes to the overall performance of the products. So these are the functional elements, and second is the physical elements. The physical elements of the products are such as parts, components, and assemblies. These are the physical elements of the products. So the physical elements are typically organized into the several major physical building blocks, which called as a chunk. So now we can understand what is the definitions of product architecture. So the architectures of product is the scheme by which the functional elements of the product are arranged into physical chunk and by which the chunk interact. So this is the nothing but the arrangement of functional elements into the physical chunk. This is nothing but the product architectures. In product architectures, the most important characteristics of the product's architecture is its modularities. So what is modularities and which are the properties we have in modularities? So in modular architectures, the following two properties. First is the chunk implement one or few functional element in their entirety. So there are the chunk in which there are the one or few functional element is considered. And second properties of modular architecture is the interaction between chunks are well defined. So there must be the interactions between chunk is in well defined. So types of modularities. So if you consider the types of modularities, there are three types of modularities. Here I show the three types of modularities. First modularity is slot modular architecture. Second is the bus modular architectures, and third is the sectional modular architectures. Here you can see that in slot modular architectures, each interface between the chunk in a slot modular architectures is of the different type from the others. So you can see that here the three chunks are shown in the slot modulars with the different types from each others. So these are the slot modular architectures. So next is the bus modular architectures. So in bus modular architectures, there is the common bus to which the other chunks connect via the same type of interference. So in this here you can see that in bus modular there are the common bus, and all the chunks are connected via the same type of interference. So here as you can see that all the interference of the different chunks are the same types. So this is nothing but the bus modular. And the last types of modularity is the sectional modular architectures. So in sectional modular architecture, as shown in the last figures, all the interference are of the same types. Here you can see that all the interference are of the same types, but there is no single element to which all other chunks are attached. So in case of slot modular architectures and bus modular architectures, there are the single element to which all other chunks are attached. But in this last case, in sectional modular architectures, the all interference of the same types, but there are no single elements to which all other chunks attach. So examples of, if you look at the example of sectional modular architectures, so the example is the assembly is built up by the connecting the chunk to each other via identical interference as we do in our assemblies. This is nothing but the sectional modular architectures. So in these lectures we learned first the applications of digital tools, which is used for the design, product designs and manufacturing, and then we learned what is product architectures and types of modularities. Thank you.